My dear sister, don't want to share sometimes. And it's hard, right? She's not listening to me. She's in her room. And it's hard to share. When I was going through my divorce, I remember I didn't want to tell anybody what I was going through. I didn't want to tell anybody. I'm in my court. I'm in my domestic court, domestic violence court. Nobody's to know what I'm going through. Nobody knew. I run up that stairs every single day and I smile to everybody and I say good morning. Nobody knew what I went through. Nobody knew what I'm going through the next day. Nobody's supposed to know. And when I had enough, like Nesta, I said enough is enough. But then my ex-husband told me that he was going to embarrass me. He's going to embarrass me. He's going to let everybody know. And I didn't want to be embarrassed. My mom told me to stay in the relationship because of the status quo. My family told me to stay in the relationship because of the status quo. And I felt like I had no one. But I had one friend. She told me,
it's your two kids.
Whatever you choose to do, I'll support you. Mm-hmm. If you need to go to court, I will be by your side. If you need anything, I will be there for you. This is not a sister. This is not my mother. This is a friend. In fact, I didn't even realize she was my friend. This was an attorney colleague. Who proved to have been my friend. And that's all I needed. That's all I needed. That one person to be there. And that's why I keep on saying over and over, if you all know somebody that is going through domestic violence, all you need to do is to save them.